care about it. Look, look forward.
Well, the room really, to be fair, the room really cleared out, by the way.
Man, the night is the purple. The purple. I love it. Another. Good times. He totally deserves it.
Darvin, of course, we just got down here from the Pop Sol, and just want to get your reflections on his moment, his day, you know, amidst you guys playing the game against his first team, Memphis, and kind of what your message is along the lines.
I mean, just, you know, what he's been able to do, was able to do throughout his career, it's remarkable, nothing short of remarkable, phenomenal. I mean, for his number to go up there, where Aaron was, that company. Short of amazing, and you know, you couldn't ask for a better human being, along with how talented he was as a player. I'm thankful, you know, I got to play against him. I got to coach him for a couple of years, and he and I remained in touch, remained friends from the process, and it's great. I mean, you know, we have Ron tonight, Pastor Kareem, and I'm gonna be a part of this, and you know, building to witness this, you know, again, as a Laker. It's humbling.
And of course, assuming you're quite focused on Memphis and trying to win this game at the same time, so do you have a final word yet on Russell? And then just how do you see Memphis is a little different without a job and what's going on with their whole situation?
Well, D'Lo is progressing, you know, according to plan. He'll go through his pre-game workout and then we'll go from there. With Memphis, they're going through a little bit of adversity, but they're going to come out as physical and competitive. You know, they have a team full of capable young players, guys who are going to go out and do their job and be the utmost professional. So we have our work cut out for us. You know, and it's not a night off because Ja's not in the lineup or Clark's not in the lineup. And they have several more players that can hurt you. And so we have to be prepared to do what we need to do. Both sides of the ball, try to get a W, much needed W.
Darvin, you mentioned coaching him two different times here in LA, tail end of his career in Milwaukee. Do you have a favorite Powell moment that sticks out? And also, can you maybe speak to the contrast of coaching him while he was still in his prime here versus in his final season?
Well, if I have a favorite Powell moment, I have a favorite Powell game. You know, my first year here, 2012, Meta had been suspended, you know, to finish the season. And we played a really young, hungry Denver Nuggets team coached by George Karloff. And they took us to seven games in the 2012 playoffs. And the game he had, along with Andrew Bynum, another guy I worked with, Powell was just, you know, he dominated that game, points, rebounds, assists, blocks. Go back and look up the numbers, but he was nothing short of amazing. It was Meta's first game back, you know, Denver again, man. Timothy Moskov, Gallinari, and Andre Miller, Al Harrington. You know, they think they just did the Carmelo trade with New York and brought back a bunch of young assets, and they really gave us everything we wanted in that series. But Powell capped off that series with a huge performance. And just the human being he is, man. Like, he's easy to talk to. He's visited practice. You know, I had him talk to the team one time pre-practice. And just his spirit, you know, the way he cares, you know, his humanitarian work both here domestically and internationally, and in the field of health and wellness, his work he's done with the St. Jude Hospital is, you know, he's an angel. He's a walking angel here on earth. And,
Paul said something along the lines of not really being able to compare himself to the greats when asked about his jersey being raised into the rafters tonight. And as a historian of the game, somebody who knows him so well, somebody who's coached and watched him play for so long, do you think he's too humble at times?
No, I just think that's who he is. You know, it's we live in a pride and ego-driven world within the NBA world. And you know, when you come across people are like Powell and what Powell represents as a human, it's refreshing. You have and the accolades and the things they've been able to accomplish, but for him, he's just a normal human being that treats every human being, you know, regardless of stature or financial prowess or whatever level, gender, age, it doesn't matter. He's just going to be Powell, and that's like just a sweetheart of a human being. And again, it's so pleasant to talk to him because, you know, we talk about things going on in the world. It's not just basketball. And he's well-versed in everything, you know, dealing with society from A to Z. So it's a pleasure. I want him to remain, but never, never change. And I know he won't, but that's just the nature of this business and the nature of our world now. It's for people to do more patting on their back as opposed to, you know, giving thanks for what they've been able to do and be exposed to.
Darvin, if D'Lo is able to go, where do you think that adds the most to you guys? Is it taking some of the load off of Dennis this last, you know, 5 games as a primary ball handler? Is it giving you an extra shot creator? Where do you kind of see the biggest boost?
I mean, obviously, his ability from the perimeter, but, you know, me, I won't draw any conclusions. I'll use them the way we've used them since he's been here. And that's a shot maker, shot creator. And just to go out there and make sure, you know, he's fitting in with what we're doing, which he has. And so the biggest thing, the first and foremost thing, is for him to go through this process and see if indeed he will be available.
You had a handful of games against Powell as a player, right?
Yes.
Do you have a favorite memory of Powell just busting you?
It's safe to say he was a lot better, a lot bigger than I was, a lot more skilled, but I was a harder hitter. I can tell you I spent a lot of fouls trying to guard that dude. But that's back when I think I was playing with Milwaukee when he first came to the league. Yeah, he's a just phenomenal guy. He won't be brass. He's not brass like that to say that dog plays the bust your ass. He appreciates me. One of the few people in the world that appreciates me.
Darvin, can I ask you, we're talking about, and I've heard this from many people who know him, what he is outside of basketball. Yeah. You said you've talked about many things. Obviously, some of those are very personal conversations, but what subjects have you guys covered outside of basketball?
I can remember, you know, he was, and he could confirm this, but I can remember he and I having conversations as player coach about, you know, all that question always would come up, what would you be doing if you weren't an NBA player or had this talent or size, the mixture of both? And I wholeheartedly believe that, you know, him going into the medical field in some capacity, I think he always wanted to be a surgeon, you know, that piqued his interest. And again, it falls right in the line with who he is. He wanted to help humanity, he wanted to help people, and better what you know, discipline, job, occupation, represents that more than being a doctor, specifically a surgeon. So says everything about him, and he's constantly, you know, working with the World Health Organization and different things like that. And that's his passion, health and wellness.
Yeah, it seems to me that it would take a special guy, special talent to be a number two beside a player like Kobe, or beside LeBron, per se. What was it about Powell that it worked?
Powell never looked at it from an egotistical standpoint. You know, he always looked at it, how can I do more? You know, how can I be better? How can we both make this work with the rest of our teammates? And, you know, Kobe, you know, he was fun to be around, fun to coach, but Kobe was a hard ass. Like, Kobe didn't take excuses. He didn't make them, he didn't take them, he didn't accept them. And he was always trying to look how he could pull more out of himself as well as his teammates. And Powell's ability to, you know, withstand that and understand that and embrace it, you know, I think it's a huge reason why he, you know, took that next step in terms of not just being a talented individual NBA player, all-star caliber player, but to be a world champion and to shine big in big moments. And I just think they had that counterbalance personality-wise and the type of approach that they had. Powell just ended up being like a big sponge, and Kobe became like a big brother to him, and it was it is amazing to watch, man. That was a hell of a 1-2 punch that they ended up